All right, we all ready? Okay, good evening and welcome to the October 7th meeting of the Lake Forest Building Review Board. I'm Ted Notes, Chairman of the Building Review Board. At this time, I'd like to ask the members of the board to introduce themselves.
I'm Fred Moyer.
Ross Friedman.
Jim Diamond.
Thank you. The board is here tonight to work together with all of you, property owners, architects, neighbors, and interested citizens to continue the long tradition that allows Lake Forest residents and businesses to work together to preserve the qualities and the unique character that make Lake Forest a special community. We recognize the personal importance of each petitioner's request. Our goal is to respect the needs and desires of property owners while balancing the interests of the community as a whole to preserve and enhance its architectural character and landscape streetscapes. For those of you who may not be familiar with the Building Review Board, the types of projects that come before us are those in which the property owners are requesting a variance to allow a home that is larger than permitted by the code, are seeking a demolition permit and approval of a replacement structure, or otherwise involve issues that could not be fully resolved by city staff. It's important to note that over 95% of building permits are issued by the city without need for any further board review. Thus, the board typically deals with the most challenging and sometimes controversial projects. The City of Lake Forest is committed to conducting open and fair meetings. To achieve that goal, the board has adopted meeting procedures and all parties will be provided the opportunity to speak. These procedures or proceedings outlined on the agendas available at the back of the room. This meeting is also broadcast on cable television. Speaking on behalf of the entire board, our objective is to provide a review process that is thorough, fair, and without unnecessary delay. And the next item on our agenda is approval of our meeting minutes from September 2nd. Any comments?
No.
I move to approve.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, the meeting minutes from September 2nd are approved. Next on the agenda is the continued consideration of a request for approval of additions and modifications to the exterior materials and roof massing on the existing residence located at 598 Rockefeller Road. I'd first like to ask if any members of the board have had any ex parte communications or other conflicts of interest.
No.
All right, hearing none, if the petitioner would be kind enough to introduce herself.
My name, thank you. My name is Victor Liu. My company is Jeremy Liu and Associates, and I'm representing the Mazar residents, the Mazar family at 598 Rockefeller. First of all, I want to begin by thanking the committee and the staff for all of your input. We were here last month, 2 months ago, and we responded to your comments. And I think as a result, we have a project that has improved greatly. So we very much appreciate it. You commented on simplifying the roof forms, reducing the mass of the roof, and to design a greater consistency of the architectural style on all of the elevations. Just to summarize, the program hasn't changed, but I wanted to go through this briefly. The first floor program was to expand the existing kitchen breakfast area at the front of the house so that it had a visual connection to the front yard and the driveway, to expand the existing garage to create more storage space, a larger mudroom adjacent to the kitchen and garage and accessible from the exterior, and reconfigure the master suite. Also, part of the program was to expand the existing front porch, which is only 5 feet to 6 feet in depth. They wanted it to be more functional and suitable for furniture. This was the proposed first floor design last month, 2 months ago, and the design was to expand the garage toward the street, the kitchen expanded toward the street, we have the new porch area, and the rest of the remodeling took place inside of the house. The new proposed first floor One of the adjustments that we made was to step back and keep the existing front wall of the garage. That helped mitigate the higher roof line and also allowed us to keep the same massing of roof forms that exist in the house as it is currently today. Still, the kitchen projects out, and the rest of the remodeling takes place inside of the house. But by pushing the program toward the rear, we also allowed the office space to project into the yard. So there is an addition. This is the existing floor plan. The purple walls indicate what's being demolished. We previously had 25% of the existing house demolished. Now we've reduced it to 14%. The south wall of the garage, the east wall of the kitchen, and we're adding a bay to the rear. This is a diagram that just outlines those areas that we're expanding. There's no wall, we're preserving the existing wall between the office and the house. This is also a site plan that just shows the relationship of the additions to the setbacks and the property lines. This indicates a trellis that was added to the program since, and that was the suggestion of a landscape designer and the owners, and I'll show you later how that, I think, enhances the elevation, the rear elevation. This is the old proposed second floor. This program, and the program was 2 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, and a recreation area. The front of the house that was, or front of the second floor was much of it was the recreation area. And that created some of the more complex roof lines. By pushing more of the program to the rear of the house, I still have the same 2 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, but the existing recreation area gets smaller, and it allows the front to be less complex. This was the submitted design in August, and in particular, some of the comments from the board was to simplify the roof lines. We have shed dormer with gable. The columns at the front were not, in everyone's opinion, a true craftsman style. This was at the time more of an eclectic prairie craftsman. And then there was the mass roof height over the garage. So the revised design steps the garage down. The ridge height respects exactly where the ridge height is as the house is set situated today. I removed the shed dormers and really simplified this roof line with presenting a gable. The gable now is more similar in mass or size and appearance to the lower first floor gables. And also it's designed to be centered over the existing front door entry. And let me show you the next diagram. That shows, this is the existing house as it's, and what I did was I darkened the lines of the roof to show the mass of the way the roofs relate to each other. The proposed design, to increase the garage space, we added 6 feet to the south, but I also thought that it would be a strong hierarchy and a good balance to expand this roof over, as I'm showing here in the hatched area, introduce the new gable, and center it over the existing doorway. This is the proposed rear elevation from August, and one of the main concerns from the board was, from the board and the committee, was the length of this shed roof dormer. And also there was a lack of consistency of the application of materials on all four elevations. Here we were preserving the existing brick. The proposed design, I built the, used the first floor structure and expanded the program over. So we have a two-story structure over the existing first floor, second floor over that existing first floor. Broke up the mass of the shed dormers and stepped them back so that they were more subtle. And then at the base, we continue with the stone, and that wraps around the entire house. Also, it's difficult to see in this photograph, but we have incorporated more craftsman style end rafters and brackets in particular points. This is the trellis that's between the office, one-story office, and the two-story structure. This is the old side elevations with a lot going on here. Now, this is the south elevation of the proposed home, where this was the old south elevation of the proposed home. We had a massive roof area because we were expanding the garage toward the east. Now it actually is situated very similar to the way that the house is today. This is the north end. This is just a quick diagram showing some of the historical influence where I tried to kind of incorporate some classic architecture from Green and Green, for instance. There's this two-story structure with a bay, the casement-style windows with grids at the top, brackets, two-foot overhangs or wide eave overhangs, and rafter ends. And this is not a trellis on the left side of the house, but it's rafter ends that with a one-story roof line, and that trellis mimics much of that. And the same with this EW Stillwell. I have a shed, I should say, I have a gable, two-story roof centered over a doorway with rafter ends. This illustrates a section through, a typical section through the house. This is the two-foot overhang and various materials that we're using. I can come back to that. And then this is a section through the porch. We're proposing, quickly, clay tile roof, a cedar beadboard underneath the eave, copper gutters in the U-shape, cedar fascia and soffits, 2x6 wood rafter tails, that's this light element here, and hardy board siding, 6-inch cedar trim above the windows, and wood Eltrex windows, and 4-inch limestone sills and stone veneer that continues around the entire house. This is a rendering that we created, and the goal is to illustrate the volumes and the appearance from the east, kind of looking from the south, and also to kind of help everyone visualize what the color scheme would look like. We're trying to use neutral colors, more of a craftsman style. The body is what they call a hearthstone. Gables are Nantucket gray. The gables, and just there was a change since we originally submitted a few weeks ago. The cedar shake that were shown in the gables, we are eliminating those and going with lap siding, and that was a recommendation by the staff. But we're changing the color. And then we have accents, the brackets, which will be this red. This is another elevation. It's the same exact home, but also we wanted to show how mature landscaping would affect this front elevation. So these are just bigger trees, and I have a landscape coordinated floor plan below. We built a model, and I'll pull that up in 1 minute, but I wanted to also show you some shots, because sometimes it's easier to understand the volumes in two-dimensional photograph. So this is moving around the house counterclockwise. This is the back elevation. This is to the south, from the south. And that's the front entry. I have a landscape plan, but we expected a landscaper to be with us here today. She is ill, so I'll be glad to answer any questions.
Thank you. Kathy and Kate, any direction?
Thank you. The board voted to continue this petition in July with direction to further refine the massing and simplify the roof forms and really look at the consistency of the craftsman style. Since then, the project has come a long way and further refined those elements of the design. Staff is recommending approval of the project. We have called out some conditions of approval and some areas to get the board's input on. Hardy board siding is proposed, the lap siding, which the design guidelines call for natural materials. We wanted to get your input on that. The shingles were eliminated. We had suggested that just in order to simplify the elevations and kind of avoid it looking too busy. So we did make that suggestion. And then clay tiles are proposed for the roof. However, it appears that they're going to be treated in a way that appears to be cedar. So we did make a comment that the treatment of the clay tiles should not be treated as cedar. And then we had also added a comment that, and you could pass it around.
Should I leave it in the box?
You can take it out and pass it.
pass it down.
Yeah, do you mind just leaving it with us?
And then the final comment was to do additional plantings in the front yard in order to sort of soften the changes to the streetscape, just to add some more landscaping to the front yard in particular, because there were also trees replaced on the site a few months ago as well. Thank you.
Great. With that, any questions for the petitioner?
Sure. Start off with the materials of the windows and what you're proposing.
The window is a, excuse me, it's referred to as the Wood Ultrex. It's by Marvin. It is a fiberglass clad only, but it is solid wood as any aluminum clad window.
Can I ask a question? It was in Kathy, it was in, Kate, it was in your notes that it was fiberglass?
Yeah, fiberglass windows were previously proposed, and I think you changed the manufacturer, but fiberglass was always proposed.
Yes,
correct?
Originally we specified Beechworth, but for various reasons we chose not to work with them, and Marvin, in my opinion, is a much more reputable firm.
Okay, and the shingles, is there a reason you're not using cedar as opposed to the clay that looks like cedar?
Right, great question. And just to go back to August, we originally came proposing standing seam metal. We have scrapped that idea, but the owner is, and the owners are interested in sustainable materials, and the clay tile, it will mimic, in a sense, the cedar appearance. In fact, I'm gonna pull up a photograph. This is disregard the style, but this is the actual material that this is actually right from the Ludo Shake catalog, and we have the rep here today. If you have any much more specific questions, he can address those, and we have samples too that we'd be glad to show you.
All right, thank you.
Just a clarification question. If you put up proposed northeast elevation, the drawing from your presentation. There we go.
The one before.
It's not the northeast.
No, I'm looking for the northeast.
There you go.
That's the original one. I changed the name just to simplify and not confuse, but this is the northeast elevation.
Yes. If you go to the far right side, the roof line there actually goes right to the end of the gable, and it doesn't on here. And so I was just going to ask you which one it is. Yeah. See, basically this overhang is, you see it there, maybe it's the angle into the shot, but actually the roof line on the far right actually dovetails.
It sets back. It should be even as
you want it even.
Yes.
Okay. I mean, obviously it gives you a little more space, but visually, you know, typically there is always
a little break.
There's a little break.
That's not a problem. I can do that. Now I figure that the gutters will continue and cross over the end of that sloping eave, and so it'll help create that visual break.
Issue was really for clarification because it's different here and aesthetically it's better, but I understand there's some other things you might need to deal with. And back in the and back to the roof, I mean, the tile company is very well known, the roof tile company, and they do all sorts of different styles. Did you look at some other variations? The comment that you're hearing is that you're actually using a tile roof to replicate a shake style cedar shake, but they're all over Lake Forest for just regular tile, and it works in a lot of historic homes and a lot of, you know, beautiful properties. So did you consider some other things that are trying to replicate that look, and do you still fall within the...
Yes, and that decision, a lot of it was based simply on maintenance and longevity.
But I mean, in terms of the style of it, I mean, you picked a style that actually is replicating another material, and I'm saying that they make zillions of other surfaces.
That's true. We did look at about four different colors. The style, I think, was pretty easy. In fact, what's great about the style is that all of the shapes vary and the different lengths vary, so it really gives it an authentic, natural look. The only decision was which color should we go with, and we picked an earth gray. But you're right, they do have other styles. They have a smooth, this has more of a rustic feel.
Thank you, that's all I
have.
Did you say you had samples of the clay roof tiles?
Yes, we do.
That would be helpful. And just a reminder to the board members, make sure your microphones are on and speak into the microphones. They're having a little trouble hearing you over the video. Thanks.
Anything else, please?
No, that's it, thank you.
Ross.
Your last proposal, what the roof material was, cedar shingles?
Standing seam metal.
Standing seam, that's right. And the gutters were?
Gutters were K-style aluminum. Copper, K-style copper,
Previously.
Okay. Previously, yes.
So, terrific exterior materials, and yet hardy board siding. A little bit of a concern in the compatibility of that with stone, a stone wainscot and clay roof, copper gutters, downspouts. I would caution serious study of compatibility of materials. Of what color stone, what type of stone is being contemplated?
We have a sample of the stone also. Rather than describe it, I think we'll bring it.
Help me with something, please. The roof structures at each end, excluding the garage, because of the overhang of the center structure, it throws off the balance, at least from the elevation of what we're looking at. But look at the balance with the centering of those gables facing the street, and yet the roofs look off balance because of the overhang of the center roof structure. Am I making sense?
You're referring to this?
Thank you.
Yes.
This line.
Right, and if you, so when you adjust for that overhang, it really cuts into the, perhaps that's simply because we're looking at this in single dimension.
Right.
But in the field,
I'm good right now, thanks.
You're going to have a shadowing effect from the overhang, but you will still perceive the, that's it. Okay.
This is about 11 o'clock in the afternoon. It's positioned north-south. So this gives you an actual shadow, the real shadow effect.
Okay, thank you. The importance of the landscaping is critical. How committed is your client with respect to the landscape plan?
Very committed in the sense that they've gone through the full design. If you're suggesting alternates I'd be glad to address that.
Again, terrific material for the drive, pavers. What is the proposed front walk?
The front walk will also be pavers. So this will be a permeable paver design, all of this, and that includes the driveway, the walk leading up to the front porch, the walk that wraps around the side and the entire patio space.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Moyer.
Yes, you mentioned the stone is coming, but my question in advance of that is at the last presentation, there was a material passed around at a very minute scale to it, little slivers of things that were flat and almost had no texture from a distance. Now, you're showing a much different texture in this drawing, so I'm assuming it's coming along with a different proposed stone.
Yeah, we've seriously reconsidered the use of that material from August. This, if I'm correct, these samples, I don't know if they represent the actual width in the modules.
Okay.
But there are wider, taller pieces.
Right, because the elevation showing things in the 8 to 10 inch vertical height, and these are much more narrow.
Right.
These are larger segments as well. Okay.
Is that an accurate representation of the color?
Yes, that's exactly what the owners have selected.
So a question would be that in the elevation drawing, is that a fill that the CAD program has introduced, versus what it's actually going to look like?
To answer your question, that's the best representation that our CAD designer was able to come up with.
No, I appreciate that. Just knowing that is important because it looks like a fill.
Yes.
And so the question is whether the material you're proposing is going to be able to achieve or approximate or come close to what the elevation is showing us.
It will be very close. Color-wise, I think you're getting a better example by looking at it. But as far as the modules and how it's drafted, it will be very simple, or how it's rendered, it will be very similar.
Okay, that's all I have by way of questions.
I have no other questions. So with that, I'd like to invite the public, if there's anyone in attendance who'd like to ask the petitioner any questions. Seeing none, I'd like to invite Jim, we'll start with you this time. Any comments?
Sure. I like some of the things you've brought back, and I think it's progressed real nicely. The only thing of concern is the fiberglass windows, as the city had recommended not in their statements. So I don't know what you're going to do about that, if anything.
We have a sample, if that would help.
If you'd like to see a sample.
Sure.
The cladding is the same color that we'll be using on the house.
Mm. I kind of wanted you to mention that this window apparently is used throughout Lake Forest and other homes.
Overall, I think there were some real nice changes made, though.
Thank you.
Bruce.
It's a solid wood window with fiberglass cladding.
It's nice to hear that you and the client believe the process has, resulted in an improvement. So it's nice that across the board the direction's moving the right way. I'm very supportive of it. I think it's I think this simplifying the roof line has helped dramatically. I think it is truer to craftsman style, and I think you've done a very nice job. I think it's a very nice looking home. I agree that the landscaping is going to make a difference, but I would think that you would want to do that because especially for a craftsman style home, landscaping almost becomes part of the way it looks, and mm-hmm. and given the client cares about renewable materials, trees are fall within that camp nicely. So I'm very supportive of it. I don't have any particular comments. I mentioned the roof line. I think you'll work that out. The only other thing that I'd share is that on the tile, tile is, as I mentioned, is used in a very regular way. I wonder if maybe there's more a knee-jerk reaction because the suggestion is it's trying to replicate something else. But I'm very familiar with this company, and they do different shape tiling all the time in older homes, and it just gives a nice, more natural effect. Whether it necessarily looks like, you know, cedar or not, I don't know if that's so much of an issue. I think if it's aesthetically it works. As a material, I think it's a good material for the home, so I'm very supportive.
Great. Thank you, Bruce. Ross.
I, too, am supportive. I appreciate the revisions that have been made. Again, I caution, however, that quite a bit of natural material, stone, clay, copper, and then the hardy board, which is kind of the fly in the ointment. And then, of course, the compatibility of all of it. So devil's in the detail with that. But I'm in support.
I participate in that support. Made great improvements, much simplified, and holds together very nicely. Just one comment in the rendering. I think it's very effective with the essentially a double fascia above the window in all those locations. And the elevation drawing, it doesn't come through as strong as it does in the renderings. I wanted to just suggest that you strive towards achieving what's in the rendering, which is really looking very, very nice. And I think it has a little, the white or the light color of the fascias is very important to the quality of what we're seeing in the elevation, in the rendering. It tends to go away and recede a bit in the elevation drawing, which may be, you know, partly due to the character of the drawing, but just want to emphasize that the elevation is really coming through very nicely. And
thank you.
I recommend supporting the project.
I'd also like to commend you for making great efforts on the design. I think you've put together a beautiful home, and a design that I think will be a huge benefit to the streetscape. The only thing I would like to make a point to the petitioner is, if you haven't seen hardy board on the side of a home, for all of its attributes, it does have shortcomings, seams are very visible. I would highly encourage you, before you make a final determination, to go hardy board, that you go actually see it applied in the field. That might change your mind on whether or not that is a direction you want to go. Other than that, I support the petition. All right, well, do I hear a motion?
I move to approve the petition as noted in staff comments and the board comments.
Well, actually, let me interrupt. Did you have anything else you wanted to say before we close out?
No, I just want to reiterate, I do believe that this process works. It's a little more, takes a little bit more time to get to that point, but we found that we're all very happy and we're very proud of this home.
Great, thank you. I'm sorry, Ross. If you wouldn't mind picking up where you left off.
I move to approve the petition in accordance with staff comments and the board's notes this evening.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Aye. Hearing none, the motion passes. Congratulations. Good luck with the project.
Thank you.
Next on the agenda is consideration of a request for approval for the demolition of the existing detached garage and construction of a replacement attached garage and an addition to the rear of the residence located at 825 Highview Terrace. Are there any ex parte communications or conflicts of interest for the board to be aware of?
No.
Hearing none. Thank you. If welcome, and if the petitioner could introduce themselves.
Good evening. I'm Mark Downing, President of Downing Safaris Architects here in Lake Forest. And being brief, I'm sure you're familiar with the packet, I'll hit the high points of what we're proposing. The existing residence, built in the mid-50s, very simple in its massing, has a detached, a non-conforming detached garage in poor condition with a small screened enclosed element at the rear. The home as it currently exists does not meet our client's programmatic needs. They have 5 children under the age of 7, and the garage being detached is a challenge. It does not have a mudroom, it does not have a rear entrance, and it does not have a first floor family living space. So what we're proposing to do, so here we are looking at the existing non-conforming garage. We're proposing to add a garage that is conforming. This is the existing residence. The site, by its nature, relatively flat in the front, but its most distinguishing feature is a number of very large mature oaks, both in the front and in the back. The topography in the front is fairly flat, but it does slope about 3-4 feet as it goes towards the south to the rear. The existing materials are a painted brick, a clapboard siding, and some shiplap siding in the gables. We took note of the streetscape. The street of Highview has a variety of different homes in different periods along the way, with the ranch house towards one side, an older home to the east. This is our proposed floor plan, where we are proposing a two-car garage, 24 feet wide, with some additional storage to the rear. They have a growing family. They need storage, a mudroom, and the first floor family living space, and a generous rear entrance. We've recessed the entrance so it does not compete with the main entrance of the house. We have specifically held the width of the main body of the house, as you'll see in the proposed elevations, so that the roof aligns. We are not increasing the scale of the mass of the house at all. In addition, this is the existing wall of the house. We are doing as little as possible to the existing house and simply trying to add on and complement to the existing mm-hmm. residence. The proposed front elevation, you can see lightly here. This is where the detached garage was. So the scale of the detached to what we're proposing is actually very similar. The materials match all the way around. The pitch of the roof matched front to back and side to side, proposing wood garage doors with some lights top, which we think are very compatible with the period and style of the house. Towards the rear of the house, the engineering isn't complete. There will be a slight drop off in grade here, very, very slight. This is the family room addition towards the back. This is a computer rendering of the streetscape of the two adjacent houses, and then the ranch house to the west and the two-story house with its garage there. We are conscious that we're proposing front-facing garages, even though the detached garage had that, but a number of houses along the street have front-facing garages as well as the houses that we have. We'd like to point out we are asking for no variations. We're matching all the materials. In addition, we have submitted to staff letters of support from both the neighbors to the east and the west and across the street. There's a few more computer renderings. The house is gray. Yes, we will continue to be that. There are some poorly scaled shutters on the house that we will be removing, and gives you kind of an idea. Any questions?
Thank you. Kathy and Kate.
Thank you. This request is for the demolition of an existing detached garage, construction of a replacement attached garage, and rear addition for more living space. It will replace the non-conforming garage with a conforming garage now. The house is a split level constructed in 1955, so the introduction of an attached garage is appropriate both for the streetscape and the style and date of construction for the home. A new driveway and curb cut will be necessitated by the garage addition, but the trees will not be impacted, the oak trees in the front. The city arborist has added a condition of approval to take the necessary steps to make sure that those are protected during construction. And as stated, you received 3 letters in support of the project. So we're recommending approval of both the demolition and the construction. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. Right, start off. Any questions for the petitioner or staff?
Yes, I have a question. The drawings note that the new roof is to be having asphalt shingle to match existing. Wanted to ask whether there has been a analysis of the ability to match the existing. In other words, have you confirmed that it's going to be possible to have a successful match?
You know, we will obviously do our best. The roof is not considerably old. It doesn't call for replacement. So it's our intention to be as close as match as we can. When aligning the roof with the existing, yes, we definitely will have concerns about the blend of that, because we thought an offset in that roof line from the break would actually draw more attention to the addition, and we're trying to really keep it as simple as possible. So it's our hope that we will be able to. I don't believe it's an extraordinary, unusual shingle, so I believe we'll be pretty successful.
That's all I have right now.
Thank you, Brett. Ross.
I'm Mark. With piggyback on Fred's comment, it might make sense if there's any risk of creating a demarcation between the old and the new roofs to simply run the new roof to the transition of the split level roof.
I see your point. Yeah. If we have difficulty, I think that's an excellent point.
I mean, it's very little additional.
I agree with you, and it's definitely something we discussed, and it's a point well taken.
I like what you've done. Question regarding the length of the existing structure as it connects to the new garage, however. Was there any consideration or modeling done to add some sort of roof feature to break up that length? Dormer?
Well, to be honest with you, no. The existing house didn't have it. I think to put a false dormer on what the portion of a house that is a ranch would be drawing attention to something that really isn't there.
I agree. On the other hand, I'm bothered by that length of roof. It almost looks like a gallery to a degree, but I would encourage maybe some further exploration of that, playing around to determine if there's anything that might subtly break that up while still being compatible with the design and the genre. That's all I have.
Bruce?
I think it's very straightforward. I think it's assuming it'll be executed well. I'm sure it will. It'll be seamless. I think
that was
our hard press for people to go by and think it wasn't done that way originally. So
that
I think it's a great improvement, and I can totally understand why the family would like to do that. This is just a suggestion. It really doesn't have anything to do with any issue whatsoever. But you're taking what was seemingly a smaller home structure ranch, and now by putting the garage on it, even though that's not living space to the same degree, it changes the sense of the home. Mm-hmm. And since you're going to do the work anyway, what you may want to think about doing is putting some kind of accent around the door and make it a little more prominent feature to the home. I think it would make it feel more substantive. And since you have a bump out now with the garage, I think it would be more in keeping with it. I just think it might be a nice feature without adding a crazy expense to it. And it certainly wouldn't complicate anything. Mm-hmm. That's it.
Thank you, Bruce. Jim?
Is there a drainage issue with the property?
Absolutely not. The property slopes naturally towards the south. And I've been there a number of times over the course. There's no indication whatsoever. But we will have an engineered site plan submitted with building permit.
I thought I had read somewhere in your notes that there was a drainage problem, possibly.
Not that I'm aware of.
Different.
Oh, okay.
There's a different one with a porch in the back, I think. Oh, you see it on there? Sorry about that.
All right, great. Looks nice. Thank you.
Good evening. The only clarification I have, are the shutters coming off entirely?
Yes.
Okay, and they're not being replaced, okay.
That doesn't work, so.
Okay. No. I don't have any other questions. With that, I invite the public, if anyone's in attendance who'd like to speak, seeing no one. Jim, we'll start with you for comment.
I'm in support of the project. I have no comments other than that. It's fine.
Also very supportive.
Ross.
Ditto supportive, but again, I referred to my comment about the roof structure. Encourage you to take another look at that.
Mm-hmm. Fred?
I'm in support of the project, yes.
Thank you.
Sure. Any other comments yourself?
No, sir.
First, do I hear a motion for the demolition of the existing garage?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Hearing none, the motion to demolish the existing garage passes. Second, do I hear a motion to construct a new garage as an addition to the existing home? Anybody?
Motion to approve, considering the comments that were made by the members here this evening, and finishing off with the comments by the staff.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So moved. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Next on our agenda, consideration of a request for approval of an addition to the rear of the residence and modification to the existing exterior materials at 1319 Edgewood Road. Do any members of the board have any conflicts of interest or expedite communications?
No.
All right. With that, welcome. If you'd be kind enough to introduce yourself.
Hi, good evening. My name is Sean Purnell. I'm the architect working with Ms. Adams, the homeowner, on this project. She unfortunately could not be here with us this evening. But what she would like to do is provide a reasonable addition to the rear of the home that would allow her and her growing teenage son to live in the house in peace. And so we'd like to basically try to keep this, while it's not visible for much of the addition from the street, we obviously want to be respectful of the neighboring properties and keep in consideration the scale and the size of the homes that are on that street. The existing front elevation of this home is a very simply masked front porch. The house has been redone at some point with aluminum siding and poorly scaled shutters. There's a variety of different window styles and sizes throughout the house. Well, the house is not in great repair. The exterior condition as part of the addition, they would like to reclad the entire house in cedar. Obviously redo the roofing and cedar soffits, fascia, new aluminum gutters. So really try to bring the entire quality of the home up in all aspects while we add this addition. On the site plan, you can see the size of the home is similar to several of the neighbors. However, the neighbor to the south has undergone a relatively large renovation and addition, which brings the home toward the rear yard approximately to the extent that we would like to add on to this residence. There's an existing detached garage. We would be a significant different distance away from that to allow the rear addition to be constructed. The addition essentially continues the roof line of the existing home back towards the rear of the property, but after discussion with the homeowner and, you know, looking at several different options of the design of the first floor plan, we did deem it necessary to bump out towards the south, I believe it was 4 feet, because the interior dimensions of the home are so tight that we were essentially creating an exaggerated hallway through the entire house, and it really did not provide an adequate amount of living space. And that was the reason I note that in the staff report, they called attention to that. In my opinion, it's a pretty critical characteristic that allows the proposed family room to be functioning and allow them to have a functional mudroom, which again is one of the drivers for this addition, especially with a detached garage in this climate. Not having any kind of a transitional space was a big negative for their use of the home. There's some minor interior work, redoing the kitchen, extending a usable family room. Right now, there really is only sort of a semi-formal living room space. And again, for her son and her son's friends, it's a very, very tight home to live in. So the other component of the addition is basically the second floor is aligned with that first floor addition, which provides a new master suite and a bathroom. There's only a single bathroom in the home right now, single full bath, so this would provide an owner's suite bathroom and then a private hall bath for use by her son. Also noted in the staff report was the rear balcony, which there's a cover, you know, a covered rear deck on the first floor. One of her desires in doing this addition was to be able to have a walkout patio from the master bedroom overlooking the deep yard. It's her favorite spot on the house, and I noted, you know, staff called out that that was unusual. It is probably the one thing on this addition that the owner is in love with, so she would ask that we would keep that as a consideration for a possibility on the final design. The elevations of the home, we try to be straightforward and simple in, you know, replicating the relatively shallow pitched hip roof all the way around the house. From the front, if you look at it in an objective architectural drawing, you can see the projection of this hip roof. However, in reality, obviously with perspective, it's so far back toward the rear of the house that it's not very visible. And there's a large tree at the corner of the home which completely obscures both the projecting bay window and the proposed addition. On the side elevation, this would be the north side elevation. It's very, very tight to the neighboring lot line. As was noted by staff, there's very little room, hardly any room to do any kind of planting to mitigate the size of the home, but the existing trees would remain, and there's substantial tree on the borders of both properties here that would remain in place. There was one small tree that would have to be removed that I noted the arborist is recommending removal of. So on the south elevation of the home, there's a simple reverse hip which would cover that 4-foot bump out. And then the rear of the home, again, there's an offset from the existing roof line because obviously to comply with the side yard setbacks, the existing house is non-conforming, but obviously we would like to keep it as the proposal as simple as possible, not asking for any variances or interaction with zoning, so we would like to offset the addition to comply with that side yard setback. I'm happy to take any questions about the project.
Thank you. Kathy and Kate, any comments and direction from staff?
Thank you. The board has recently seen several similar projects along Edgewood Road. So this is a request for a two-story rear addition. They also proposed to do some substantial upgrades to the exterior materials, which staff is very supportive of. As Sean noted, there's an existing elm tree at the rear of the house that will be removed as part of the project. The city arborist has gone out there, and the tree is in poor condition, so he has okayed that removal. We did point out the two-story deck is proposed at the rear of the addition. Given the small lot in this neighborhood, the proximity to neighbors, it doesn't appear that a two-story deck would be appropriate. So we did make the recommendation that it be just a patio or an at-grade patio. And we also called attention to, it appears that there are a variety of window types proposed on the addition. We had made a recommendation that they really look at doing a consistent type of window that would be appropriate for the time period of the date of construction of the house. And then we also had made a suggestion that the expansive wall on the south elevation be broken up a bit with additional windows to kind of break up that portion of the wall. But staff is recommending approval of the addition with the recommended changes. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. Fred, we'll start with you. Any questions for the petitioner?
Well, just a minor question. In the first floor plan, the curved element or feature that comes out from the kitchen towards the rest of the spaces, is that the dotted dash line, is that a ceiling drop with soffit of some kind?
It is. It's probably something maybe not to be included here, but yes, it's just an arched transition between kitchen and family.
Right. Okay. No, it looks very, very nice. No, I have no other questions right now.
Could I interrupt for 1 second?
Yeah.
I just have one comment. We have discussed with all of the neighbors the design from the beginning of the process, and they're very supportive. We did not have anyone write in at the appropriate time, which is unfortunate, but they both, neighboring properties, were aware of the deck design and were really positive about what they're doing to the property here.
Thank you. Ross?
Overall, supportive, inclusive of the offset. I think that that actually adds a feature to the home of interest. I completely agree with staff's comments, however, regarding the rear two-story deck, wooden balconies. I believe it would be much more successful without that in this setting. What is the material along the wainscot at the base of the structure?
An existing concrete material there. The original foundation is exposed, so that would be intended to be kept, but painted and, you know, brought up to the level that we could with the rest of the exterior finish.
So that's exposed concrete that will be painted to
the painted block
to
right
emulate
now.
The block.
That's what it is currently. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. No question.
I just want to reiterate about the deck also, if you could come up with something else other than two-story.
Understood. I think it could very easily be made a single-story deck with railing. Obviously, there's a poor quality one there currently. We need to have a transition down to the grade level, but we could remove the post, we could remove the second-story deck, and resize an appropriate window from the owner's bedroom, removing the door.
And the windows, did you have any intention of trying to get them all the same?
I understand staff's comment, and I respect that. One issue we're having is facing the neighboring property on this bump out, we have both a furnished master bedroom wall on the second floor and flanking windows on either side of a fireplace on the master, on the family room level. So these four windows in particular are relatively small and are tough to get in a double hung window that would be consistent. The scale and proportion would be really off. The existing home has windows roughly of this size and scale currently on the front and side elevation at the staircase. They're an elevated fixed window. So I thought it would be appropriate to match that secondary kind of window in this one instance.
Thank you.
I don't have any other questions that haven't already been raised. With that, I don't see anybody here to ask you any questions. Unless, Lori, you'd like to ask anything. With that, I move to any comments for the petitioner.
Okay. Yes, the thing that bothers me about the deck, more than that there is a deck, is how it's done. What I'm getting at is that the repetition of the railing, balustrades and such, identical downstairs and upstairs, combined with the fenestration being identical down door and windows and so on, it rings for me a duplex. It comes to me as a two-story, two-tenant building, and they each have this feature, which is more like an apartment house.
And reflective of an urban environment.
Yeah, well, and that too, but to me it detracts from the image, and admittedly it's on the private side of the house, the backyard and so on, it's not the front of the house, but to the extent that it's seen at all, to me it detracts. And so, but before going, and then also, by the way, I'm sympathetic to the interest of the owner to have a deck functionally and to enjoy being able to be out there at the second level. So I value that desire. So in between have and don't have, I think there could be middle ground to be looked at. And that, just as a suggestion to explore, it may not be successful, but I think it's worth exploring, would be instead of doing the balustrated railing at the second level, to do a deep planter box that's 8 inches above the deck. In other words, no one's going to fall through, kids aren't going to go through, and then a deep planter with flowers and so on and so forth, and make it not this repetition of what's down below. And by the way, driving by the house, I see the owner's doing wonderful things right now with pumpkins spaced out and so on. So I know that that would be a wonderful feature if it could be used to have flowers and other things. And so anyway, that's my thought. I'm not on the edge of yes or no on the deck. I think there might be a middle ground where you could have it functionally but not have the detracting repetition of up and down balustrades. That's my view. Otherwise, by the way, I think it's terrific. The space, the first floor space is just gonna be wonderful living space. Very nicely done.
Okay. And I don't have anything further. I'm sorry, yeah.
That's okay. Russ?
I'm supportive of the petition with consideration to the rear terrace deck that we've discussed.
I'm also very supportive, and I'll just build on Fred's point. I do think there's some middle ground there, and not to pretend to do your work, but I do agree that I think by having the post that goes up as a support post for the second floor and having them identical, it does make it seem more duplex-oriented than a part of the home design. So what you may want to do is knock those support posts all together, let the bottom be a regular porch. And actually, if I read it correctly, it's 6 feet out. Does that sound right? Extends out 6 feet. Think of the second floor as, because she, in a sense, she wants an exposed balcony that she can go out on. So basically, you can just drop the support, drop it back from 6 feet down to 4. So she has a space to go out, but now you have a stepped look from below and up, and you don't have the beam that goes to the top. But anyway, I think there actually is a solution there that would make it feel like it matches the house and give her the ability, the family, the ability to go out there and enjoy the backyard. So that's my only thought.
Thank you, Bruce. Jim?
I am supportive of the project with the comments that were made also.
I don't have anything to add that hasn't already been addressed. So with that,
I move to accept the petition with respect to the staff comments and board comments this evening.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
You opposed? Motion passes. Thank you. All right. Next on the agenda, consideration of a request for approval of revisions to previously approved plans for a new residence at 101 East Lewis Avenue. Changes to the approved exterior materials and windows are requested. Any ex parte communications or conflicts of interest that haven't already been identified?
None.
All right. Thank you. Lori, would you mind bringing it more in front so it's not blocked? Thank you.
Like right in front of you, like this?
Yeah.
That's good.
Thank you.
A little tilted right now. I have to do a grade change.
Some site balancing work that's needed.
I know, that really bothers me, right?
Okay. Welcome back.
Thank you so much. I feel like I should say we need to keep stop meeting like this. Okay.
That's fine.
Yeah,
thanks.
Great, thank you.
Okay. All right, so I'm Lori Glatley with LK Homes. Jim, we haven't had the pleasure of meeting. Hello.
Actually, if your company was Integrity before, I did meet
It you. Was not. Okay. It was not. So I'm going to just make this really succinct because it's three cosmetic changes that we are asking for your approval of tonight. We have a homeowner now involved, Mike and Keely Bosa. Mike is here with us tonight, and he grew up in Lake Forest, so they're gonna be bringing, he's looking forward to he and his wife Keely coming here and raising their children here. So it's really exciting to be working with them, and they're old family friends too, so that worked out great. So they came to us interested in the house, but they had a few changes that they wanted to make. Ironically enough, some of which this board has had a lot of discussion about. So we, there have been a lot of changes since that time, though. So the staff felt that it was important for us to come back to you to get your approval. And so that's what we're doing tonight. So the first thing is the color of the house. It's really just slightly different. It's a very minor change. It's gone from light gray to dark gray. And I would say, I'm going to use myself as an example. When I want to demask myself, kind of like today, I put on dark colors, right? So actually, I think having the house darker does the same thing. It's the same kind of effect. It sort of brings it in anytime that you go darker. So we actually think that this is a benefit and something that the board had wanted all along. We just kept looking at different ways that we could make the house seem less massive. So we think the color that they've chosen actually really works to that. The second thing that they're asking for are the a change in the windows from white clad to the dark clad. And there's an example here for you, the exact window. This actually is very much in keeping with the Adams Colonial style that we had originally chosen. If you were to go back into the 1800s and early 1900s, you'll find that many homes at that time had dark windows with white framing. And it was just a personal choice, as it is today. And this look has kind of circled back, and we are seeing it more and more in new homes that are being built. It's something that people have an interest in, and we don't feel that it changes the architectural style at all. And actually, by changing the color and making it a little darker, those white windows really pop out, where having the darker window, I think, helps it blend in. So rather than looking at the house and saying, oh, look at all those white windows, I think it softens the windows a little bit. So actually, I think that's of benefit as well. And then the last element to discuss is the stone knee wall. I'm sure that you recall we had a lot of conversation about stone on the house. I just want to make a slight adjustment to the staff report. My recollection is not that we were told we couldn't do it. It was that we were having a hard time agreeing on how it should look. And you may recall that we had talked about doing it on the center piece of the house, and then Bruce had suggested maybe we put it on the side, and we brought that back. And Ken and I just decided to just take it off voluntarily because we just wanted to get through the process, and we felt if we could minimize, that would help us get through the process. So we just took it off. It's something that Mike and Keely really want. It was one of the first things they came to us and asked us about, completely unsolicited. They had no idea that we had gone through this process and asked for any stone on the house at all. So I think that it really does add to the aesthetic value of the house. I think it's just, it is also in keeping with the Adams Colonial style. If you go back and look in the 1800s, a lot of the bottoms of the houses were the brick foundations, and they were either brick or stone. And so this is just really sort of replicating that look, but it has changed over time and evolved because we don't need foundations like that anymore. But this is still reflective of that same design feature that you would have in an Adams Colonial even back in the 1800s. And one of the other things that staff recommended was that we might want to consider adding more landscaping to further, I'm going to use the word hide for lack of a better word, the stone. I would take exception to that. The goal of the stone is because we think that it adds a nice architectural element to the house. We think that it does a nice job of breaking that flat cedar front that's just so plain. And having the landscape the way it is, it allows you to get a peek at the stone, but you don't see all of the stone. It is softened by the landscaping that's there now. So we actually think that the way it's designed as is very pretty from the street. The last element that was brought up, the last thing that staff recommended was that the stone go all the way around the house. We did discuss at length how we wanted to address the stone. If you were to look at the east and west elevations, there's really nowhere to put it too much. So that just leaves the southern elevation, which no one except possibly the gardener will ever see because of the fence and the landscaping. And there is certainly precedent in H.O. Stone, as well as in the neighborhood I live in, Lake Forest Heights, with homes that have their architectural detailing on the front, whether it's brick or brick and stone, and then just cedar on the sides. There certainly is a lot of precedent for that, and that's what Mike and Keeley asked that we would present to you. So that's what we've done. So those are the three elements. We don't feel that they negatively impact or change anything very much, but certainly understand and respect the process and wanted you to have an opportunity to comment on that.
Thank you, Ori. Kate or Kathy, any comments and direction from staff?
This is a fairly straightforward revision to previously approved plans. Because there was so much discussion previously about the stone specifically, we wanted it to come back to the board for review. The board had made some comments to suggest removing the stone to simplify the elevation. So they are now introducing it on the front elevation again. So we wanted to get your thoughts on that. We did make the recommendation that the stone be applied consistently on all elevations. As we would do for any home design, the style and detailing should be applied to all four elevations. So we are recommending that if the stone is approved by the board, that it be applied to all four elevations. And then the color palette has changed, but we agree that the darker color could potentially sort of minimize the massing of the house and sort of sit more quietly onto the property. So we're recommending approval with your thoughts and deliberations on the stone. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. Jim, any questions for the petitioner?
No, not at this time.
Thank you.
Quick question. Are there any trees in the property now? I see.
Yes, there's a lot of trees on this property, actually.
So you just did this so we'd have a clear view of the
home. That's exactly right. We wanted you to have a clear view of the house.
I wanted to just confirm that we weren't changing anything.
Yes, there's actually a really big one on the right-hand side and another one just maybe slightly off the left side. Maybe you could still see it. I think it's a walnut tree to the left and an oak tree to the right. But there are a lot of trees on this property.
That's what I thought. I just wanted to confirm nothing changed there.
Yeah.
No other questions?
Russ.
I have no questions.
Fred.
No questions.
The only question I have for you is, have you considered a more muted paint color for the trim? It's such a stark contrast, particularly now that you're going with a darker window and a darker house. Mm-hmm.
It's not something that we've considered, but it's certainly something that we could talk to Mike and Keeley about. And we are trying to be so sensitive now that it's not our home and let them make the choices for what they want, but it's certainly something that we can consider and discuss.
Thank you. I'd like to open the floor for any questions. Sean, come on. Ready? Okay. All right. With that, we'll start with Fred. Any comments for the
No, I actually concur with the chair's suggestion of a more muted trim. It really is quite strong, and to me, it makes the front door look like a black eye because it's in such a great contrast. And I was going through my mind whether the door should be brought up in a lighter tone so we can see it, know that there is a door, because it's really lost right now, and I think the contrast is quite harsh, quite frankly. I know you're looking for contrast, but this is maybe more contrast than is beautiful. So that'd be my comment.
Thank you, Fred. Ross?
I agree entirely with my colleague's comments. It delineates the home in a manner that I don't believe is where you would prefer to go. As well, is the landscape plan calling for the same plant material along the front facade, or might it call for some taller structural plants in front of the stairwell?
I would love to see something taller there. This is the original plan that was drawn, and when we're out in the field working, we've discussed that we want to find something that's a little taller there that will be compatible with the other landscaping, that will kind of come up into that space
integrate
and fill
space.
A little bit of that void. Right. Absolutely, I agree 100%.
That would soften that.
Yes, for sure.
And I concur with staff's comments about, although it's more costly, and maybe the gardener will be the only one to see it, but the wraparound stone. That's all.
Bruce. Well, just reinforcing, there are always going to be some differences of opinion up here. I don't have a big issue with the white trim. I mean, it's personal taste. I think you're getting a reaction that you want to think about because it's you're living in it, but you're going to have other people live in the neighborhood, and I don't think that's your goal to have a reaction. Say, you know, I think it's kind of odd that it's so bright white. I do think with the trees in the front, it'll break up those lines, so you're not going to see the linearity that I think people are suggesting here. So I just think it's worthy of the exercise. There may be just a softer, as you know, there are about 9,000 shades of white. And typically when you show it in this context, it's going to look brighter than I think it would be, so I don't have an issue there. With respect to the knee wall, I know we went back and forth. I think part of the reaction that we had about it, the stone knee wall originally, is because the whole front facade also was stone, so it really added to that. So I think when that disappeared and you had taken the rest away, it wasn't a topic anymore. I actually think it adds dimension to the home, and a little differing opinion. I almost look at it as a facade treatment. So I understand our mindset, which is we want consistency around all four sides of the home. It's part of our charter. But if I think of it as a facade treatment, just to add character to the front of the home, I don't feel the requirement to have it go all the way around. So a little difference of opinion there. So I'm fine with it the way it is and not continuing in the back. And that's it.
Jim.
I think the trim around the windows does take away from the front door the way it is right now, the lighter color, and you'd get a lot more punch from the front door if it were something else. And the facade, the stone, I'd like to see it go all the way around also. That's it. I'm supportive other than that.
I've already spoken about the color, and I would encourage you to consider another trim color that's, again, not so stark. In terms of the stonework, I think it's attractive, but I do also think that it should be that design followed around the house. And although you do say that it's hidden from the back, with the way your lot is situated, especially when the leaves fall in the winter, the back garage side of that house actually will be visible along stone and on Buena rather. And so I do think it's important that style be carried around the house. Other than that, I have no other comments. Lori, would you like to speak to anything?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
With that, I invite Fred or anybody here to make a motion to.
I'll make a motion to approve. As reflective of the discussion this evening and staff comments.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Motion passes. Aye. Thank you, Lori.
Thank you.
Well, Sean, I was all excited that our last petition hadn't shown up until I realized it was you.
Ditto. And you were hiding. And you were hiding behind the rendering.
I thought you were wanting to hang on the excitement that this last petition.
Oh, we had the Cubs game.
All right. Last item on our formal agenda is the consideration of a request for approval of an addition to the front of the garage, a second floor addition over the garage, a rear addition, and overall exterior alterations to the residence located at 347 Cherokee Road. Representing the petitioner would be Sean Purcell. I ask if anyone on the board has had any ex parte communications or conflicts of interest.
No.
Hearing none, Mr. Purcell, welcome.
Good evening again. This is really kind of a rare privilege to be able to go through this again. I love it. This addition is attempting to solve a few things for the family. This is a colonial revival style home on Cherokee. The second floor is very tight for their family. They would love to be able to expand some additional living space over the garage. In addition, this home was never designed with any kind of a mudroom or transitional space. Seems to be a theme that because they are set back quite a ways from the required front yard setback, it would be optimal if they could come forward from the existing first floor to provide a functional mudroom. After discussions with staff, some of the drawings have changed quite a bit since what you probably received in your packet. The existing home is non-conforming with the side yard setback. It protrudes roughly 2 feet into the setback. And after discussion, we've elected to modify the proposed sunroom at the rear of the home so that that would offset and comply. In addition, the second floor master bedroom addition over the garage without too much heartache can be made to comply also. The garage is really where it gets very tough to comply with that setback. It creates kind of a very odd offset in the front of the garage and makes the garage all but unusable. So in this first floor plan drawing, you can see that the existing 12-foot side yard setback runs through the entire house. And obviously, as a different component to this project, we would have to ask zoning to take this 7-foot bump out that we're proposing here and allow it to align with the existing garage to create a fully functional two-car garage. If we offset that 2 feet, it creates a very odd space, does some very odd things on the front elevation, and makes the garage all but unusable, which really defeats the purpose of going through this addition in the first place. This sunroom addition in the rear of the house, that was relatively simple to scoot over a foot or so to make it comply. That's not too big of an issue there. On the second floor, again, you could shift this from the existing exterior perimeter line over to comply with the 12-foot side yard setback. We would still get a bedroom that is a little tighter than they would have hoped, but it solves the purpose of the addition, which is to provide a new owner's bathroom and relocate an existing bedroom into a larger space overlooking the rear yard. When we look at the what I'm calling a composite front elevation for your review, it differs slightly from what was in your packet in that the second floor addition no longer goes all the way to the edge of the existing garage. As staff notes, this complies and also does have the benefit of stepping a subordinate mass over the garage to soften the extent of the massing of the addition. So while this portion of the addition complies, if we go below that to the front elevation, the garage shown here would not comply. And again, obviously we would need approval for this, but it does allow the garage door to be centered under the gable and details in a way that's pretty natural with the front of the house. The other thing to note here, the existing porch on the house that we saw earlier is an asymmetrical porch tied into the garage roof. They would like to eliminate that. In addition, they would like to eliminate this painted brick, which occurs only at the front elevation, and replace that with a cedar shake style siding that would be consistent with the remainder of the home. They would also like to add shutters. Noted by staff, those would be a wood constructed, appropriately scaled shutter. I think we had shown that primarily on the front elevation. If it's critical to extend that to all elevations, we could do that. I have not had a chance to take a look at which windows work and do not work according to the size and scale of the windows. But eliminating this connecting piece allows us to develop a more symmetrical and balanced front elevation, eliminates that kind of leaning tie in with the garage sloped roof, and then it allows us to provide another gable, which again kind of softens that big expanse of this colonial revival roof that we'll be eliminating with this addition. At the rear of the home, the sunroom would project out in a similar way that the garage does in the front, providing a reverse gable, consistent shake style siding, larger windows appropriate to the use as a sunroom. And I don't believe, this is an elevation that we've discussed with staff, but I don't think that you had seen a picture of. In your packet, there's an elevation which shows a small, almost transom style window here mm-hmm. in the master, but unfortunately, we would need an egress window, and if we eliminate that side going out to the existing garage perimeter, we lose our ability to put the egress window on the side of the house, so therefore it would have to go at the rear. In order to do this, you would have to create, this is the existing roof, which is a cathedral ceiling on the inside. The homeowners would prefer not to modify. There would be a small reverse dormer pan detail to allow a full-size egress window for the master bedroom. Happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Kathy and Kate, any comments?
Thank you. This petition will go before the zoning board for a variance for the garage, and the petitioner has made adjustments. We had recommended in order to not require variance for the second floor addition, they've stepped back that addition both so that a variance would not be required and also because as far as the massing goes, it's a bit more subordinate to the main mass of the house. We had also made some comments about the proportions of the proposed windows, particularly on the sunroom, and they have responded well to those and looked at making those adjustments. Vinyl windows were also called for. I'm not sure if changes have been made since then, but vinyl windows with interior mutton bars only were proposed. Those are inconsistent with the city's design guidelines, so we had made a recommendation that the windows either be aluminum clad or wood with interior and exterior mutton bars. And I believe that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Kate. Jim,
sure.
Lead us off.
Regarding the windows, did you consider SDLs?
No, the owner would like to go with an aluminum clad window. The interior and exterior mutton bars are acceptable, so that was more my error than anything else, and calling them out as a vinyl window, I think I just ticked the wrong box on that day, but they were always intended to be a wood to match the existing.
And the window, no, I think that's all. That's the only question I have. Thank you.
Just clarification, the rear elevation, what you put up there is the alternate rear elevation, that's what you're proposing.
I have to apologize because I believe, you know,
the one we have here doesn't
I think we
have
three different versions of this floating around.
Yeah, it doesn't have
around. The
reduced
and
second
this would
floor,
be,
but the larger windows are part of that.
It would be identical except in the sense that there would be a 2-foot setback on that far left side, which is not shown in this version. So.
Great.
For the second floor.
Yeah. Correct.
But that
correct.
Is the one that you are, the alternate is the one that... Okay.
That's correct. Right. The that windows, the everything is identical except for that.
Yep.
Bump
got it.
In. Yes.
Thank you.
Awesome.
I have no questions.
Yeah, I don't know if I can combine a question with comment, but if I phrase it right, it'll be a question. But
start with what?
I don't know if I can do that. I'll tell you, an issue that bothers me a lot when I went out and looked at the site and so on, and with the drawings in mind and so on, is the elevation that you call right side elevation. Mm-hmm. For a couple of reasons. One, it's really going to be seen a lot. Because the house to that side is L-shaped, and this is their primary view for them. Even another house on that side is primary view, and anybody coming up the street, that's going to be a primary view. And I think that right side elevation is, although you know the attempt to make it as good as it can be, it's really quite awkward. Highly irregular. It has nothing to do with the rest of the house, simply because the massing is forcing it to be what it is. So what I would, inclined to suggest at least exploring, and it may have some downsides, but I would go to the second floor plan in your here or there, wherever you are, and take a look at the second floor plan, because that would be the best way to explain what I think might help.
Is this the alternate second floor plan, or is this the original?
This is the alternate. This is the conforming second floor.
Is that in the, I've only got one, I think I only have one second floor plan. Maybe there's.
One that was originally sent out comes over to
the. Does the alternate go to the 10 foot dimension as my plan does? Everything goes to the 10 foot dimension on this, on the plan I'm looking at.
Yes, those. I
except for the rear, the very rear.
I don't have
porch.
That one with me.
Yeah, so let's assuming that the second floor is going to the existing 10 foot, which is 2 feet beyond the property, or the setback rather. Suggestion would be to look at reducing the width of the garage by 2 feet, holding it to the setback line. That takes it to 19 feet and change instead of 21.5, 19 feet 5. And doing the same on the opposite side so that the second floor mass comes down to the ground. And the elevation then would be a gable with a mass that comes down. It would have the character of the other side of the house, which is a mass that comes to the ground with a gable roof. And then on this side, a smaller gable, but same massing. So it becomes a coherent mass, you know, repetition of that form, different scale, different dimensions, but same form. Right now it's, you know, like almost the backside of an industrial building. Right, it's got goes here, it goes there, it goes down there. The downside is that you lose 2 feet of garage width, you lose 2 feet of the family room on the other side, and you might need to pull the porch back a little bit to maintain its offset. But I think the massing and the appearance of the house would be dramatically improved.
Is that a question?
I think that was a statement.
I understand.
Following you that? It's hard to explain.
I appreciate what you're saying. It's been a real back and forth struggle, I think, to try to obviously maximize the amount of space and create a tenable structural condition inside the bearing of the home. But at the same time, on the front elevation, realizing that pulling that second floor back, while it does create some issues for the primary elevation, the perception from the street, it does seem natural to step that in and to soften as it tapers down to the neighboring property, which is a bit below this house. It does help to try to mitigate the bulk of what we're trying to do here. So I appreciate what you're saying.
I wasn't suggesting stepping the second floor back. I was keeping it as you have it. The expanded, relocated bedroom would be the same as you show.
I understand.
And it would just come down intact to the ground. But on either side of it, there would be a 2 foot setback. So we do see that form coming down.
I see.
And that would make a much better elevation for the neighbors and people going up the street.
All right. There was no one in attendance. I actually do have a couple comments. Can't forget myself. If you could bring up your west side elevation. One of the things that I tend to agree with Fred on is that the proportions of the second floor feel offset. And I wanted to understand if you had considered expanding the second floor Southmore, which would give you a bigger bedroom. I mean, there are a couple, number of benefits. One, you'd have a more balanced look. You get a bigger bedroom. You avoid this pan feature, which I'm not a fan of pans. They tend to leak. I think there are a lot of advantages, and curious why you kept that bedroom as small as you did.
I'm in 100% agreement with you. This was primarily a consideration to the owner who, this line of the expansion on the second floor is meant to maximize and retain the volume ceiling in their living room intact below. If we push out any further, it really eliminates the entire cathedral ceiling in the back part of that home, which is her favorite room in the house. It's very light, very bright. It's a really beautiful room on the inside. And literally all of those decisions are back-ending from that priority. Frankly, in a perfect world, I think you would match this offset to the rear. Yes, it would solve several problems at once. It would create sort of a triple stacked gable, which would appear much more natural. I'm perfectly open to that suggestion. That's something I could certainly deliver back to the owner, and we could revisit the discussion about the volume ceiling.
Thinking out of the box here.
Yeah.
You have a closet on that west side elevation taking up a great deal of square footage. Now, it might not be typical, but what if you had you pushed out on the south end and created a closet that was effectively starting 2 feet off the ground?
Step it up.
Step up the closet. Now you've bought yourself all that square footage lost on the west side of the house, and you haven't compromised the cathedral ceiling underneath.
That could be a potential if we took advantage of a cathedral ceiling on the second floor as well, which obviously wouldn't have a visual impact to the outside. It would give you that headroom to pick up an extra couple feet. And it's right at that critical point. After that, it's a non-issue. So that's a very interesting idea. I'd be perfectly happy to discuss that with them.
I'm indifferent. I'm just trying to think of solutions to how to get a more... You were talking about losing the 2 feet and compacting your bedroom. I think there are opportunities that you can enhance the exterior elevation and gain more room all at the same time.
That's a great point. Yeah, I mean, the front and rear then would look very much the same, but it would solve some of the messy issues on this elevation, which I agree with 100%.
The next question I have is regarding the chimney. You're doing a lot of changes to the exterior material. The brick of the chimney, how can you speak to how well it fits with this new style of side, the shake style that you're...
I don't think it's atypical, especially for this style and period of home. It hasn't been painted like the remainder of the brick does, which is, you know, I'm very happy to get rid of that. It's a huge pet peeve of mine, that painted brick. But the natural red, which is a pretty decent color, frankly, I don't see any problem retaining that.
That speaks to everything I had. Any comments that you have for us to address, rebut?
No, I think you covered a few issues that I'm in an ongoing discussion to work with. Staff has been really helpful with this project, actually. We've had a lot of back and forth, which I apologize if it gets confusing by the time we get to you. There's two or three different versions floating around, but I really appreciate that feedback and cordial response. It's amazing.
Great. Go ahead, Bruce.
If you could actually put up the side that the chairman was just speaking to.
The side, yeah.
Yep. Regardless of how you take some of these thoughts and work it into that, I don't know if you're what other details you're looking to put on there, but I think that idea of the industrial look is part of the fact that there are no decorative features at all. So we've talked about shutters on the front of the home. I just didn't know if you were going to try and somehow incorporate some of those decorative features on the back. I think that would help make it seem more home-like. So that's the consideration. And also, that's the door, just a step up to a doorway in the center.
It's a utility door from the garage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You might want to just think of adding a little more.
A little overhang, perhaps.
Yeah, something to it. Because, sure. Again, I think that's the sense. It just feels so bland, and it looks,
this
it
entire
looks very narrow and
diminutive.
And because it is more visible to people, I think if you put a little more substance to that, and then put some other decorative features around the windows, I think it would, regardless of how you solve the other roofline issues, I think it would just make a little better.
Yeah, per staff's comments, the windows, the quality and sizing of the windows, the shutters, disbursement throughout, we'll be addressing that.
Good. That's all I have. Thank
you. I did just want to make the point that since this does need to go to the zoning board, and the zoning board has to look at hardship, I think the zoning board might struggle with portions of this project and things like adding an overhang that comes out because that house next door is really impacted. So I just wanted to be clear that there's a couple competing things here.
But I'm saying it might, even if it's just bigger, I mean, I just think you could put a bigger decorative frame around it without bumping it out necessarily. That's all, just to make it seem like it's more...
Well, and you also have that freeze board, or I'm not sure what the right term is, on the below the second floor roof lines. I don't know if entertaining the same feature on the first floor across, that just helps, that band would help break that up. Something to consider. And I'm sorry, because looking at it one more time, I'm just, you know, that the one window in the garage.
Yes.
I think that.
That's existing, but it, I think
yeah,
it has to go.
Not matching.
It's, we're doing enough work here that it should just get axed and brought back in line.
Right, it would it would make it, I think it look flow better.
Yeah.
Okay.
Was there any thought to, because this rear room is a sunroom, making those windows on the south elevation or west elevation any bigger? Or just not to touch them because they're existing?
No, the sunroom is newly proposed. In looking at that first floor plan, the decision was made to really emphasize the glass on the interior facing, the private portions of that. This is very close to the neighbor's property. They do have a room that projects back almost alongside of this. They wanted a small amount of light coming in, but they'd prefer to use that as fireplace and bookcase and really direct their attention inward.
Okay. All right, I promise you that was my last question.
Thank you, sir.
Any other questions or comments from the board?
Nope.
Hearing none, and for our viewing audience at home, to the extent they're not watching the Cubs game, no one else is here, so there is no public comment. With that, do I hear a motion to approve? Let's see, there's no do I hear a motion to consider the request to approve the addition to the front of the garage, the second floor addition of the garage?
There's enough substance to the comments this evening that it may make sense to continue this and see the next iteration.
Do I hear a motion? You move.
That
was your motion?
I move to continue the petition to respond to the comments and suggestions this evening, and we revisit it.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none. You're close. I mean, I don't think you've got far. Just some tweaking would be great to see. So.
Because we have to appear before zoning, and
exactly.
I don't really feel that that's an issue. Mm-hmm. I really love to get their impact and come back to you with
understood.
The final design
yep.
in perfect. Stone, so we're not having something very
good. Very good. Thank you very much for your time, Sean. With that, that concludes our formal agenda. I don't see anyone else proposing new business. Kathy or Kate, any business for us?
You do have a special building review board meeting scheduled for Thursday, October 29th.
Right.
The item on that agenda will be the Laurel and Western Avenue petition. We have sent notice out just for those who may be listening at home. Focus will be here again at 5:45, and we'll provide the opportunity for residents to come up, look closely at the boards, talk with them between 5:45 and 6:15. Your meeting will start at 6:30. We have not yet received updated materials from Focus, but we do expect to receive those by the end of next week. And again, for those watching at home, we would expect to have materials on the website by Tuesday, October 20th.
Thank you, Kathy. All right.
I
that concludes our business.
I move to adjourn.
Cubs are up 3-0.
All right, go Cubs. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Go Cubs.
Good night, Gracie. Yeah.